T-Man 978 Chill Review.
Hello everyone, T-Man 978. Right now I'm going to be looking at G.I. Joe Classified Series Special Mission Cobra Island, Gabriel Barbecue Kelly. He's a Target exclusive. He's showing up in stores. I think he's been showing up in stores, but you just have to be lucky. He's number 32 in the ongoing G.I. Joe Classified line, as you can see. Here is the barcode, if that can help you in any way, shape, or form. Just go to their website and pray. Much like the rest of their figures, this one is cool. This one is good. I like it. I like him a lot. I've been messing with him for a little while, and he's covered in details and whatnot. As you can see with this harness all over his body, it hinders any type. Their ab crunch, non-existent. He does have that ball right there, and they made it seem like extra effort to make sure you can move right there at least. And everywhere else, he's good to go. Let's look at his boots real fast. You see the red knee pads? I've seen these knee pads before. Everything else on his body looks to be new. I don't really feel like looking at every one of my figures to try to figure out where they got the body parts from. But I like you have the hints of red in certain places. That's cool right there. This. Yeah, the elbow pads and knee pads are definitely familiar. Everything else seems to be new. Let me aim up a bit. So you can see this helmet. See his neck right there. That's cool. Top of his helmet. See this up close. Has all those warnings and whatnot. This. And yeah, you may have noticed all his accessories are on his body right now. It's cool. This isn't like gung-ho. You can actually lift this up. That's not going anywhere. Thank you for figuring out how to do that. You also have this one right here hooked in here. And he has his hose, which since I've been purposely not watching other people's reviews so I can get a feel for this on my own. The hose comes separate. It attaches via a long peg right there. That same long peg is on his little gun right here. No doubt this is for shooting out anti-inflammatory agents and whatnot, but with this guy being part of G.I. Joe, I'm sure that he can hit a little button and change it to something else to like burn through doors that won't open with the axe and whatnot. Shoot acid like that, or shoot lasers to fight Cobra. I would not be shocked. Yeah, the hand fingers are a little bit stiff, but he can get that gun into the hand, and there is a hole in a barrel. This axe, lift that up. Looks like this. Cool. There's a little knuckle duster down there. I guess this is more his more combat axe, but he can shove that into the hand. Do this. Oh yeah, this is what his back looks like without this backpack on there. That came out while I was struggling to get this in his hand. But you can do that, of course. And of course, he can hold this. I kind of like the bigger axe more. It seems a little bit more dynamic. And pardon my crude way of doing stuff. I don't feel like doing a whole bunch of editing. So, there's that. So, as you can imagine, he's just as poseable besides the ab crunch as the rest of these guys. So, you shouldn't have any problems getting him into something that looks cool. Like that right there. Here he is running, chopping down the door while getting prepared to shoot out some fire with his little gun. Awesome! But let's fully show you his articulation. The head is on the typical ball hens. You get a lot of range on that, just the ball alone. The hens, his neck at the base seems to rotate a lot easier than a ton of other figures, so you get a lot there. So you can look up a bit, a lot. You can look down, you can tilt and do just about any and everything you want him to do with that neck. Shoulders go out there. He has the butterfly that can go back a lot, come forward a lot. They did cut this out to give him the range or ability to make sure his arm can come at least straight, but it's not going across his chest a lot. And let me make sure I zoom in on that stuff right there. But of course you get the typical double hinge elbows. Let's get the full range. Both hands do this motion up and down like that and rotate. Like I said, he probably has a fully functional ab crunch under there, but you ain't gonna be able to get nothing out of that. But you can get this, which is cool. You will probably have to heat this up, pop his arms out of the socket, and then you can get this vest off. But then the end results, I don't know if you'll be happy with that. Drop down hips. The legs, I'll have that axe right there. Typically, they can do the full splits. And typically, when the little holster isn't getting into the daggone way, typically when you drop down the hips, they can kick up slightly more than 90 degrees. You can kick back. All of this is soft material on top of hard material as normal. Thigh swivel. That. Boot swivel. Feet kick back. Feet kick forward. And you get ankle pivot. And he, of course, has peg holes in the bottom of the feet. But I like that. But let's say you don't want this to be a flame retardant gun. You can just have this gun without that hose there. And let's see. Let me see something. Maybe we can, if you don't want to lose the hose, maybe this can fit up into here. Yep. There you go. Just worry about bending things and whatnot. I do worry, since this isn't like, it's a pliable plastic and not rubber. Maybe it'll stay good for a while, but yeah, things like that do worry me, because this type of material wears out over time. But yeah, you're really good. I like them. Let's get you some obligatory comparisons, because somebody will be upset, even though these things are all basically the same height. I hope you guys appreciate comparisons, because it took me a minute to find this guy. He was not with my other G.I. Joe for some reason. Anywho, here's Barbecue with a bunch of other 6-inch Hasbro products. Yeah, I like him. He comes with some cool accessories. I love that he can store every accessory that he has. I'm not going to do my typical complaint. If you've been watching my G.I. Joe Classified series playlist, you've heard me say several things that I want these things to have. And I don't want to keep doing that. But yeah, what he does have is good. What he can do is good. I didn't expect him to have good ab articulation outside of the lower waist, which is really good. So I guess I can't complain about that. So he is a good figure at the end of the day. I like him. Thank you for watching this video. Until next time, T-Man978, out of here.
Figure action. That one's me. Join the Syndicate Toy Hunters Facebook group. Link in the description. Click, click the videos. Click the f***ing videos, baby. Click, click the videos. You should really click these.